Oh yeah, you're not wearing any shoes. You better watch out, Penny.
So I stepped on a Lego.
And then he said, you can't step on a Lego.
And you know what I said? I said, I can.
Yes, I absolutely can. But here's the thing.
I can.
And I lied about it.
You know, like a liar.
Like a liar would.
You know how you talk to your parents.
Hi, I'm
Holy shit, Ryan.
And he played Caramel Dancing seven times in a row before they unplugged the
Caramel
DDR machine.
But then my friend, who's also named Chongo, decided, no, we're gonna play one week.
One speed over Beethoven. And then I shot the Moira with a scatter arrow.
And here's the thing about scatter arrows.
They're not around anymore.
They don't exist anymore.
So something was clearly up.
So something.
I might have been hacking.
Something was
awry. Like a hacker does.
Something was awry with this scenario.
Why don't you eat ass, wear no shoes, and really sell the asylum look?
I'm so glad we brought up the John Mulaney thing, because I actually just put a fucking...
I'm so sorry.
John Mulaney.
I saw that in front of my very eyes.
And then I got solo.
Or Kill Reinhardt, either one.
Can you believe that?
Solo altered.
In
and
a
then
multiplayer
I got solo
game.
Altered.
In 2019!
I thought to myself, someone doesn't know how to play Overwatch. But here's the
And then I realized,
but he
did kill me.
He was
here's
being
the thing.
Disrespectful.
And you know how I knew this? Is because he teabagged me right afterwards.
And if you don't
right
know what teabagging
after
is...
after the kill.
Right after he solo ulted me.
And if
like
you know, a teabagger does.
So I suppose you could say that I already got teabagged 120,000 times.
And then, to top it all off, he got play of the game.
Play of the game, and everyone on the team has to watch me get teabagged?
And it wasn't
even
good.
Schmuck?
And it was a solo ult.
You're telling me that in that entire 8-minute game, no one had a better play than a solo ult?
I get on my keyboard and I type aggressively. I type very, very aggressively.
So aggressively, in fact, that I lost my Q key. Now how am I supposed to search for my dire questions?
Or should I say, questions?
And to make the situation even better, Q is what your ultimate is bound to.
So now how am I supposed to put out my toes?
How am I supposed to solo ult this person in good conscience when I can't even ult?
Fun fact, this is the most exposure I've had to John Mulaney.
Oh, he's
they were
so
being
funny.
Toxic in the chat.
Toxic in the chat. So I concocted
so
my
here's
ultimate
the
strategy.
I decided I would shoot her in the head. And
so she couldn't do it
she
anymore.
She wouldn't be able to do it anymore.
Pretty genius, John, you may
pretty
say.
Pretty genius, you'd think.
You might think.
Foolproof.
But here's
well,
the problem
you might
with my
think.
Foolproof plan.
Hanzo,
it wasn't foolproof. Here's the problem with it. It wasn't foolproof.
Suddenly, as I'm aiming for the head, I'm down. What?
Turns out there's a Hanzo. What? Right there.
Behind me the whole time.
So I go to the chat and I say, Spamzo, behind.
For those of you that don't know, Spamzo
let me
is
teach
Overwatch
you something about
slang.
Overwatch.
It's the hip lingo for the youngsters.
But here's the thing.
But here's
the
thing.
I was aimbotting the whole time.
Those of you that don't.
So really, I'm the asshole.
So really, I'm the asshole here because I was aimbotting. You know, like a cheater.
So I thought
you know, like a cheater.
So I
you
thought
know.
To myself.
Like a cheater.
I said, John. Myself said yes. I said, if you're gonna be an asshole, why don't you play Reaper?
Come. And I said no.
Despite what you might think, not all toxic DPS are equally toxic.
So here's the
what
thing.
You might not know is.
So here's the thing. They're called steamed hams, despite the fact that they're obviously grilled.
So he says to me, it's Aurora Borealis.
You know, like a liar.
Like a liar.
And so I ask him, because, you know, I was curious. I ask him, can I see it?
And he says no. And then he force-femmed me.
For those of you that don't know, force-feminization is the process by which.
Force-femming is a quirky little new trend.
It emerged around the early 2000s. Unless you're a transgender.
We could say anything in this like sort of inflection. It'd be funny. Like, for instance, here are the instructions to make a Pop-Tart. So step one, remove the pastry from the packaging. And now, step two, I want you to make sure you're paying attention here because this is a very real instruction on the Pop-Tart. Step two, insert it into the toaster vertically.
My young friends get mad at me all the time for filming things on my phone vertically. So what I did was I put my toaster on its side.
Hold on.
Just now, know what you're thinking. That's a fun little loophole.
Steven Universe is garbage, and here's why.
I'm here in my garage. I just bought this new Lamborghini here. It's fun to drive up here, and it's fun to drive up here in the Hollywood Hills, Chad.
So for those who haven't heard, let me fill you in. Horny people have no rights. Horny people are not protected under the Constitution.
And I said to him, well, gee, I've been saved by Fox. How swell.
So I said to him,
don't you dare make Tom Lee say
did you say to
lines.
Me, you little bitch? I'll have you know I graduated top of my class in the Navy SEALs.
But he
and I've been involved in numerous secret raids on Al-Qaeda.
Now here's the thing. I had it back.
You know, like
now,
a liar.
I'm lying.
Of course I'm war torn.
Of course I'm war torn.
Driving a Porsche over the floorboards.
But here's the thing. I was using way too many napkins.
Now, and the year was 2101, and war was beginning.
Now, here's the thing. Zoe 101 is a TV show from the early 2000s.
Water, earth, fire, and air.
And here's the thing. Air.
Long ago. Like 12 years ago, at least.
At least.
At least.
The four nations lived together in harmony.
That rat bastard, the Fire Nation, decided to show up, you know, like an asshole, and ruin our fun.
So, I was sitting out in the city, minding my own business. I wasn't hurting anybody. I was just fine. All of a sudden, TV turns on. I take a look, and this tall man is looking at me, and he says, I've come to make an announcement.
Shadow the Hedgehog is one of many young hedgehog friends who live in a world of imagination known as the Sonic the Hedgehog Extended Universe.
So we sit there admiring the scenery. And then she turns to me and she says, and I quote, hey, has it been about 20 seconds since we checked our lemon tree? And she was stealing our lemons, you know, like a whore.
Like a whore would. And then he pulls up right next to my vehicle, and this actually happened. And he says, you're supposed to be the fastest thing alive?
And I said,
and I'm like, God, Jet, you fucking dick.
So he says to me, wow, not going so fast anymore. And I said, just wait till I get out of this thing. And he said, ho, 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 ho. You know, like an elder statesman of a car.
Hey guys, just got to play the game, by the way.
He says, John.
Oh,
is that so?
Like an older mustachioed automobile would.
So they tell me harder, better, faster, and stronger? I can barely even get out of bed in the morning.
By noon.
And then she put up an ice wall. And I am not a fan of that shit at all.
She pushed it.